Ladies and gentlemen, in this presentation we will address aircraft noise seen from the perspective of stealthy violence. The definition of stealthy violence is a type of violence which is usually not seen as violence at all, but which leads to delayed destruction spread across time and space. And in the case of Schiphol, the impact of the violence created by Schiphol is depicted in this slide. It concerns an area of 2.1 million people, and this is mainly caused by the fact that 6 runways are usually used. Our government tries to minimize the impact of this violence by a few winged formulas, which are that aviation should be in balance with the environment, that it's altogether not too bad, that there will be quieter aircraft and thus less nuisance. And there are positive developments such as airspace review and more precise flying, time-based separation and performance-based navigation, and these will all help tremendously. And last but not least, the government will reduce the number of flights. But let's look at these issues point by point. Is aviation in the Netherlands in balance with its environment? According to the new norms and enforcement system, there are primary runways which have the smallest number of people living in the area. But still, many people do live under these so-called primary runways. The secondary runways are only used during peak hours, but every day there are 5 peak hours with 3 or 4 runways in use over a period of 1.5 hours. The third measure is that 2 runways are only used in extreme weather. But both runways are often used with the prevailing westerly winds and maintenance during 5 months, which causes frequent deviations from the preferences. It is not too bad. The rules are based on international LDEN regulations. But LDEN is a calculation of noise which underestimates actual measurements, which you can see in the slide. On the x-axis are the calculated decibels, and on the y-axis the concording measured decibels. And you can see that the calculated decibels represent a huge underestimation of the actually measured decibels. According to the recommendation of the World Health Organization, the maximum allowed decibels is 45. But around Schiphol, the noise pollution for 1.2 million people is far above that recommended 45 decibels. The government tells us that aircraft become substantially quieter every year, but on the slide you can see that data analysis shows that the claimed annual 1% reduction of the maximum noise has not been materialized. Then the government tells us that if aircraft become quieter, the nuisance will decrease, but LDEN offers insufficient protection against noise that increases over time because slightly quieter aircraft allows strong growth in numbers. Then the issue of positive developments. Our aviation bill states that growth is only possible if nuisance is reduced, but the aviation bill creates space for 800,000 flights. Performance-based navigation and time-based separation leads to concentration of optimal fixed routes. But those living below are extra burdened by a maddening number of flights, so-called noise gutters. Then the promise of reduction in number of flights. First of all, the overall reduction is only intended for a period of 3 years, and night flights are only reduced between 24 and 5 hours, where at least 8 hours of sleep are healthy. And these flights will be added times 10 during the day. So although living and flying do not go together, instead of flying less, we will get sound adaptive buildings. This means living in bunkers where you cannot open a window, let alone sitting in the garden or on the balcony. Even if you don't think it bothers you, it will still affect you. Noise is a threat to health and causes lost years of healthy life. So in conclusion, the chronic exposure to sound with its repetitive nature is why aircraft noise is perceived as violent. The penetrating and screeching sound that makes escaping impossible, even in one's own home, affects the social life of citizens in the vicinity of Schiphol in a very negative way. A perpetual clause prohibiting new residents from complaining is a travesty of justice and moral standards. The only solution to noise nuisance is a significant reduction in the number of flights. And with respect to those conclusions, let us remember these quotes from Arthur Schopenhauer. People who are insensitive to noise are also insensitive to arguments, to thoughts, poems and works of art. Noise is the most malignant of all interruptions. It destroys thoughts. And where thoughts disappear, only empty-headedness reigns. Thank you.